Hello everyone and welcome to today's market commentary. So on higher time frame in Nifty, what we can see is there's a trend line resistance coming up, and not only that, on daily time frame we know that 11,600 is the pivot point. R1 of this month stands at 11,016 or 11,600. Not only that, so this is a confluence of resistances, horizontal resistance and trend line resistance coming up. Along with that, till now Nifty is been moving in a channel. So if we draw a horizontal line here, so this is a horizontal line, and if we compare the slope of Nifty's movement, so it started at 45 degrees, then went on to 60 degrees, and now currently it is at 75 degrees. If we draw another a line connecting the lows of all the candles, it had gone to somewhere around 80 to 85 degrees. So this indicates an overbought signal in Nifty on higher time frame, but we'll come to a conclusion only when Nifty faces a resistance here and takes a U-turn. But as of now, on very higher time frame, that is on weekly time frame, what we can see is Nifty is approaching confluence of resistances, and the angle in which Nifty is moving, it is also approaching near to 90 degrees. So whenever a stock or index, if the angle in its price movement is more than 90, is more than 80 degrees, then definitely it will start to correct. So we hope that whenever Nifty reaches its strongest resistance zone, that is R1 of this month, it definitely will face a resistance and come down. Now on a weekly time frame, enabling the pivot points, Nifty has already crossed R1. And in terms of resistance, the next level of resistance in pivot points, that is R2 of this year, is at 12,160. So there might be a small correction, and then Nifty might continue its upward journey. But yes, as of now, definitely there seems to be a correction happening. RSI is also in a good momentum, but only thing is the angle with which Nifty is moving is a matter of concern here, and there is also a confluence of resistances. Now coming down to lower time frame, so this is the lower time frame. So Nifty is fastly approaching its resistance levels. Second thing, bearish divergence is still there in Nifty. If I draw a horizontal line in RSI here, bearish divergence is still there. So prior top of RSI, the value then was around 76.7, and currently the value of RSI is 74.85. So when Nifty approaches its resistance zone, that is 11,600, if this RSI bearish divergence is maintained intact, then definitely Nifty is going to fall back. But we need to see how fast Nifty is going to go there and how fast is it going to return back. So 3 points here. First is on daily time frame, we could see RSI bearish divergence, and on higher time frame, that is on weekly time frame, we could see that Nifty is approaching its trend line resistance. And we also have 10,611 pivot point R1 of this month exactly here. So this becomes a confluence of resistances. Now if you see the slope of Bollinger Band upper curve, even that is also going up. So angle matters here. So whenever price is going up, it should go slowly and steadily. Only then it will maintain its strength. If it goes all of a sudden, then there are chances that it will fall all of a sudden. So angle with which Nifty is moving and confluence of resistances on the upside. Next is RSI bearish divergence. These three things are hinting a small fallback in Nifty. That means it might retrace back. I'm not saying that it is going to be bearish, but a small correction can definitely be there in Nifty. Similarly, in Bank Nifty also, on the higher time frame, we could spot. So this is the trend line resistance in Bank Nifty too. Now again, in Bank Nifty, we can draw this. So as per chart patterns, we can call this as a rising wedge. But we'll not go into the nitty-gritty of the terms. What matters to us is the angle of the price movement. So even in Bank Nifty, the angle is going up. Price is approaching its trend line resistance. Now the price level at which currently Bank Nifty is, that is R1 of this year. So if I zoom in a bit, just observe the blue line here, blue horizontal line. The high made today is exactly the yearly pivot point. Now on weekly time frame, Bank Nifty is exhibiting a bearish divergence. So all we need is a strong U-turn here to be bearish. Otherwise, it will just cross this R1 and then again it will face a resistance near this trend line resistance. Confirmations are not there for us yet. We are just drawing patterns and we are awaiting price to come there and then give us a confirmation. But it is our duty that we'll draw all the patterns and we'll wait for the index to give us some reversal signals or continuation signals. Now on daily time frame, this pivot point, yearly pivot point, is in confluence with the monthly pivot point. So R1 of this month and R1 of this year, both are in confluence. So here we might expect a reversal in Bank Nifty. So RSI bearish divergence is still there here. So if we connect the highs of the candles here, and similarly if we connect the highs of RSI, then definitely there is a bearish divergence here. RSI making a lower highs and price is making a higher high. So then definitely a reversal can be expected in Bank Nifty, because confluence of pivot points here and there is also a trend line resistance coming up. Of course, the trend line resistance is somewhere 500 points away from the current price level, but a small impact can be seen. If Bank Nifty doesn't face a resistance here and if it goes up, then definitely R2 of this month will act as a strong resistance, because there we have trend line resistance from weekly time frame and R2 from intraday daily time frame. So this can act as a confluence of resistance. So as of now, we are expecting a reversal in Bank Nifty. If not now, then definitely at R2. So this was Nifty and Bank Nifty. Now let's go to my stock picks for the day. So first is SRF. So there's a trend line resistance breakout in SRF and price is settling above that. Now immediate resistance for this, or we can call it as a target also. If SRF settles above this trend line resistance, 1940 is our next level of target. We can say 1940 to 1966 as the target zone. So this is our target in SRF, and if it goes above that, then definitely we have a very good bullish run coming up in SRF. So this is going to be the final target for us. So let it settle down above this trend line resistance for the day. Then you can keep 1940 to 1966 as your targets for the month. And if it closes even above that, then 2208 are your next level of targets. Similarly, ACC was there in my scanner. So in ACC, there's a confluence of trend line resistance as well as horizontal resistance. So if ACC settles above this, then first target for the month should be 1601, and then the second target for the month should be 1630. So let it settle down above this confluence of resistances, and there's no resistance in terms of pivot point as well. So this is going to be a very good trade if it settles above this confluence of resistances. Even RSI and the other indicators like pivots and Bollinger Bands are also supporting. They are indicating bullishness in this stock. The only resistance point is this. Even Star also, there's a resistance zone here. So above 423, if stock settles above 423 today, 441 is your target, and above 441, R2 of this month should be your target, which is 461. Based on plain chart, if 441 is crossed, then it's going to be a good bullish rally. But we'll also take the support of pivot points. So we'll keep our second target for the month as 461. So above 423, 423, or I can clearly say that is R1 of this month. So R1 of this month is in confluence with prior swing highs. So this is going to be a strong resistance for the stock. So if it is able to surpass this, then going above this will not be an issue for the stock. So above 423, this stock is bullish until 461. Similarly, Godfrey Flips. Even in Godfrey Flips, already the stock has surpassed the trendline resistance. It settled above that. Now it is facing a resistance near this horizontal one. So above this, we'll be bullish on the stock. Now, booking profits is an issue in this stock because there are several swing highs and there is also R1 as our resistance coming, which is coming up. So first we'll try to book our profits near 857. And then at every swing high, you need to book your profit. If you're not comfortable trailing it until the stock reaches its prior swing highs, then you can just exit at R1 or the immediate swing high, which is 875. So even this is going to be 3-4% of movement in the stock. So that is also enough. So above this horizontal resistance, 857 and then 875. Ambuja Cements. So there's a confluence of resistances here. First is the trendline resistance starting from here, connecting the swing high and extending it towards the right. So that is going to be the first level of resistance. And next, the swing high itself is your next level of resistance. So this confluence of resistance, if it is taken out, then there will be a good up rally in Ambuja Cements. So targets are R1 of this month, which is 245, and then 252. So let it settle down above the swing high, which is 235.5, and above 235.5, 245 and then 252 are your targets for the month. ACC we have seen, ICICI Prudential Life. So there's a resistance zone on the upper side for ICICI Prudential Life. So it is, people are accumulating the stocks again here. That is the reason we are seeing a congestion zone. So once this resistance zone is broken out, then 462 is your next level of target. So in between that, for this month, you need to book your profits at R1, which is 445. Is Hindustan Unilever. Even in Hindustan Unilever, we have a confluence of resistances. First is trendline resistance here, and second is the prior high. So both these resistances will act as a strong barrier for the stock. So aggressive traders, what they can do is, if stock settles above this 1765 level at the EOD, then you can just enter into the stock keeping 1780 as your first target and R1 of this month as your next level of target. So this is Hindustan Unilever. Now similarly, we have Ultratech Cement. So Ultratech Cement is also surpassing its resistance levels. So this is the prior horizontal resistance. So for the first time stock came there, it faced a reversal and again for the last 2 days also it is trying to cross this resistance level, but it is not able to do so. Now today it is trying to settle above that level. So as per the chart, R1 of this month should be your target. Oh, the next stock is even Balkrishna Industries is also there. Even in Balkrishna Industries, there is a trend line resistance above which we can be bullish on this stock. Mostly these are the stocks and indices. I think we have forgotten ITC. Yeah. Yes, even ITC is also approaching its previous resistance. Since many days or since many market commentaries, we have been tracking this. Now here is the support zone for the stock. So twice stock took support here and that is acting as a strong resistance now for the stock, which is 307.4. So once stock closes above this 307.4, then we can expect a strong rally, bullish rally in ITC. And then there's Pidilite also. So in Pidilite, strong trendline resistance. So this is now invalidated, the horizontal resistance. So above this trendline resistance, even Pidilite is also going to be bullish. So R1 is your first target, and then this prior swing high in confluence with R2. This is going to be your target zone. So let Pidilite close above the trendline resistance and then keep this as your final target for the month. So these are the stocks and indices for today. Thank you all for joining.